إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech and the best of speech is the book of Allah. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance that we have is the guidance of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray and every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثم أما بعد. عن أبي ذر جندب ابن جنادة وأبي عبد الرحمن معاذ من الجبل رضي الله عنهما عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: اتق الله حيثما كنت، وأتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها، وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. رواه الترمذي وقال حديث حسن وفي بعض النسخ حسن صحيح. On the authority of Abu Dhar, Jundub ibn Junada, and Abu Abd al-Rahman Mu'adh ibn Jabal, may Allah be pleased with the both of them, from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who said, fear Allah wherever you may be and keep your duty to Him, and follow up every evil or sin that you do, every bad deed with a good deed, so that it will wipe it out, and behave towards the people with a good behavior and a good character. This hadith is Hasan in the Sunan of al-Tirmidhi. As we wrapped up loving our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, obeying him, recognizing his greatness, we look at one of these hadith that he gave that was short but all encompassing. An advice that covered the rights of Allah upon his slave, that covered the right of a person upon themselves and the right of others upon you. So let us evaluate this beautiful hadith. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, اتق الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah wherever you may be. Taqwa, from وقايا, to protect. Here, meaning to protect oneself from the punishment and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by doing what He commanded and ordered and staying away from what He forbade. So fear Allah when you're alone and when you're amongst others. Fear Allah knowing that He sees you at all times, so that you avoid sin even if you think you're in private. Fear Allah when you're in a state where you're receiving blessings, where you're receiving blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by praising Him and saying Alhamdulillah. Fear Allah when you're in the state of trials and being tested, by being patient and calling upon your Lord so that you remain patient. Fear Allah in every situation, again, whether you're amongst pious or impious people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commanded us with taqwa. And we should be aware that never can we hide what we are thinking or what we are planning to do. قال الله يستخفون من الناس ولا يستخفون من الله وهو معهم إذ يبيتون ما لا يرضى من القول وكان الله بما يعملون محيطا. Allah says what means they may hide their crimes from men, but they cannot hide them from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for He is with them by His knowledge, by His ilm. And when they plot by night in words that He does not approve, and Allah ever encompasses all that they do. Our Prophet ﷺ made this the goal in his life, to always achieve the state of taqwa. And he would ask Allah, أَسْأَلُكَ خَشْيَتَكَ فِي الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Oh Allah, I ask of you to give me fear of you, to give me that state where I keep my duty to you in matters that are not seen as well as matters that are witnessed. Umar ibn al-Khattab, he asked Ubay ibn Ka'b, who was very knowledgeable when it came to the rulings of the Qur'an in general. Ubay ibn Ka'b was up there amongst the elites of the ones who had the knowledge of the Qur'an. So Umar asked him, what is taqwa? He asked Umar, do you ever walk along a thorny path? And Umar radiallahu anhu, he confirmed this. He said, what do you do with your garments that you're wearing? He said, I hug them tight to myself so that I'm careful, so that my clothing doesn't get torn. Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, he said, this is taqwa. Taqwa, that you're cautious with how you live your life, so that you do not sin and earn the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who are the muttaqeen? Who are those possessors of taqwa, who live in a way to put a barrier between themselves and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They are the ones who perform the obligatory deeds as much as you are capable, and the one who remains away from the forbidden and the doubtful matters. Some scholars also say that it is also a recommendation, the ones who do the recommended acts and stay away from those acts which are disapproved. Allah said, لَيْسَ الْبِرَّ أَن تُوَلُّوا وَجُوهَكُمْ قِبْلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ وَلَكِنَّ الْبِرَّ مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْكِتَابِ وَالنَّبِيِّينَ وَآتَى الْمَالَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ ذَوِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينَ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآت الزكاة والموفون بعهدهم إذا عاهدوا والصابرين في البأساء والضراء وحين البأس أولئك الذين صدقوا وأولئك هم المتقون. Allah, He clarifies for us who the muttaqun are. He says, what means, it is not righteousness that you turn your face towards the east and the west, but righteousness is the quality of the one who believes in Allah and believes in the last day and believes in the angels and believes in the books and believes in the prophets, and he gives his wealth in spite of his love for it, and he gives it to the kinsfolk, to the orphans, and to the poor who beg, and to the wayfarer, the one stuck in travel, and to those who ask, and to set the slaves free, and to those who establish the prayers, and they give the zakat, and who fulfill their covenant when they make it, and who are patient in extreme poverty and ailment and disease and stress and anxiety and at the time of fighting during battles. Such are the people of truth, and these are the muttaqeen. May Allah make us from them. Allah, He warned us to have taqwa. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullah haqqa tuqatihi wa la tumutunna illa wa antum muslimun. Allah says, what means, O believers, have taqwa of Allah. Fear Allah and keep your duty to Him, as is His right, as He deserves to be feared. And do not die except in a state of Islam. But be mindful, my dear brothers in Islam, be mindful not to attribute taqwa to yourself and to think that you have achieved it. Be mindful of this fact, that you don't think that by your actions you have achieved that level where you are from the muttaqun or the muttaqeen. Allah says, فَلَا تُزَكُّ أَنفُسُكُمْ هُوَ أَعْنَمُ بِمَنَ اتَّقَى. And so do not ascribe piety or righteousness to yourself. Allah knows best who has true taqwa. Like iman, taqwa goes up and down, and it has levels. So obey Allah, remember Him and thank Him. Strive your best to obey Him and run to Him in repentance when you err or when you sin. Allah said, وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. And the good end, paradise, Jannah, is for the people who have taqwa. May Allah make us from them. The second portion of the hadith, وَأَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. And follow up the bad deed, follow up the bad sin, any sin is bad. Follow up the bad deed or the sin with a good deed so that it will erase it. Even those who have taqwa slip. None of us are perfect. كُلِّ بَنِ آدَمْ خَطَّاءُ وَخَيْرُ الْخَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. Every child of Adam sins, commits mistakes, but the best of them are those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةً مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أعدت للمتقين الذين ينفقون في السراء والضراء والكاظمين الغيظ والعافين عن الناس والله يحب المحسنين. والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ولم يصروا على ما فعلوا وهم يعلمون أولئك جزاؤهم مغفرة من ربهم وجنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها ونعم أجر العاملين. Allah says what means, and be quick in your race for forgiveness from Allah, and a paradise as wide as the heavens and the earth, prepared for the muttaqeen. So Allah will give us some of their descriptions. Those who give in charity in tough times and when they have wealth coming into them. Those who give in charity, in prosperity and adversity. Those who repress their anger and hold it back. And those who pardon men and forgive others. Verily Allah loves the doer of goods, the doers of good deeds. And those who, when they've committed some sin or evil, or they have wronged themselves, they remember Allah and they ask forgiveness for their sins. And who can forgive the sins except for Allah? And who do not persist in what wrong they have done while they know? For such, the reward is forgiveness from their Lord, and gardens with rivers flowing underneath, yani paradise, wherein they shall abide forever. How excellent is this reward for the doers who do righteous deeds according to Allah's orders. The scholars interpret the bad deeds, the majority of them, as the minor sins. But some of them said they involve the minor and the major sins. With regard to the good deeds, some of them considered this the tawbah, the repentance that you make when you sin. And others said it's good deeds in general. But what we know from abwab at-tawbah, from the doors of repentance, is that after you make a sin, to increase in doing in good deeds, to help elevate your rank of hasanat and eliminate that sin. So the evil deed, it's either going to be removed by the angels that record, or the responsibility and the punishment for it will be removed. And it seems like this latter view is the strongest, that the deed will still be recorded. We each have an angel over each of our shoulders. Each one of us over our right shoulder recording our good deeds, over our left shoulder recording our bad and evil deeds. They will record everything so that you see it on the Day of Judgment, but the punishment for it will be wiped away, because Allah says, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ. Whoever does a good equal to the weight of an atom, they will see it, and whoever does an evil or sinful deed, they will see it. But inshallah, your tawbah, your doing good deeds, will wipe away the evil sins. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam had the way, the best of ways, to give us a concise amount of words, a short narration, but filled with so much meaning. In this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, اتق الله حيثما كنت. Fear Allah wherever you may be. واتبع السيئة الحسنة تمحها. Follow up the evil deed with the good deed so that you may erase it. Erase the punishment from yourselves. والله أعلم. وخالق الناس بخلق حسن. And behave towards the people with good behavior and with good character. How many times, ya ikhwan, do we stress good character? How many times do we keep reminding one another with the good manners, the good morals, the good character, the good behavior that Islam enjoined upon us to have, so that we could be rewarded by Allah the Most High? Ibn Rajab, he considered having good character as being a characteristic of taqwa, meaning you cannot have taqwa completely if your character, if your behavior, if your manners, if your morals are not good. Our Prophet ﷺ, when he was asked about a deed that I could do so that I may enter Jannah, he said, Taqwallah wa husnul khuluq. He said, have taqwa of Allah, fear Allah and keep your duty to Allah. Act in a way to distance yourself from Allah's punishment, and have good manners, have good behavior. ثُمَّ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَكْمَلَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِيمَانًا أَحْسَنُهُمْ خُلُقًا. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said in this hadith that's in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and the Sunan of Abi Dawood, وَصَحَّهُ الْأَلْبَانِي, rahimahullah, he said, the believer with the most complete iman is the one who's best in behavior and character with the people. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من شيء أثقل في الميزان يوم القيامة من حسن الخلق. The Prophet ﷺ, he said in this authentic hadith, also in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad and the Sunan of Abi Dawood, the heaviest thing on the believer's scales on the day of resurrection is good behavior and good character. We hear these all the time, but we constantly slip into that mode where we are not good to the people, where some people don't want to even face you, deal with you, hear from you. They hear your name or hear your voice and they want to run the opposite way because of how your character is. The family members, from the wife or the husband, the children and the parents, these are most deserving of that best character, let alone the brothers and the sisters in Islam, let alone the neighbors that we have, let alone all of humanity so they may come to Islam. Our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنُ لِيُدْرِكُ بِحُسْنِ خُلْقِهِ دَرَجَةِ الصَّائِمِ الْقَائِمِ. A believer can reach the level of the person who prays every night and fasts every day. You can reach the level of the one who does that many good deeds just by you having good character and good behavior. Our guide was the best of mankind, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وعائشة رضي الله عنها قالت عنه كان خلقه القرآن. عائشة رضي الله عنها, she said, his character was the Quran. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told us, إنما بعثت لأتمم صالح الأخلاق. Our Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, in the authentic hadith, he said, I have been sent to for the purpose of perfecting good morals and good behavior, good character with the people. We will end the explanation of this hadith on this, with this last narration from Abu Umama radiallahu anhu, who said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, أنا زعيم ببيت في ربد الجنة لمن ترك المراء وإن كان محقا وببيت في وسط الجنة لمن ترك الكذب وإن كان مازحا وببيت في أعلى الجنة لمن حسن خلقه. This hadith, which is Hassan in the Sunan of Abi Dawood, and Sheikh al-Albani, he authenticated it. The Prophet ﷺ, he said, I guarantee a house in the surroundings of paradise for the man or woman who avoids quarreling, avoids arguments, avoids arguing with other people, even if he's right. A guarantee for a house on the outskirts of Jannah. Then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, I am a guarantor for a house in the middle of Jannah, in the middle of paradise, for the man who avoids lying, even if he or she, for the person who avoids lying, even if he or she is joking. And the last portion, and I guarantee a house in the highest part of Jannah, in the highest parts of Jannah, for a man who made his character good, who behaved with the people in the best of character. So my brothers in Islam, اتقوا الله حيثما كنت. As the Prophet ﷺ said, اتَّقِ اللَّهَ حَيْثُمَا كُنْتَ. Fear Allah wherever you may be. وَأَتْبِعْ سَيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. Follow up any bad you do with a good deed so that you can erase it or erase the punishment of it. وَخَالِقِ النَّاسِ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. And behave with the people with a good character, with good behavior. So many people can come into this deen just by how we behave with them. And so many can be repulsed by this deen just by how we behave with them. So be warned of this, and may Allah make us of those who's on the day of resurrection, whose scales are heavy with good character, good manners, and good behavior. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimina wal muslimat wal mu'minina wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka anta sami'un qareeb al mujib al da'wat. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.